so pleased to say I've witnessed you become a wonderful, caring and beautiful young lady next. And it fills my heart with pride to be your father.
Cool.
Yeah?
We're getting married!
We're getting married!
The fact that I'm still here to share this very special day with you, privilege second to none. That said, you'll always be my baby girl, and I love you, and my love for you infinite.
About handing over my person, it was just at the right time in our lives that you found yours. Rich couldn't have asked for better. And take care of my princess.
I believe I'm getting married, according to the brief. I've been told, when asked, to say yes.
The rabbit goes over. It's been a while since I was at school.
How did he pick up our scent?
He's been sniffing us for years.
To Richard, what a great privilege it has been to meet the man who now is not only my son, but he's a colleague of mine. And I'm so proud of you, my boy. Thank you for all you've done, and thank you for being in our lives. I wish you every happiness and every success. You have a wonderful foundation. You have a wonderful wife. You are no longer my cookie. Enjoy, my boy. Remember only one thing, respect one another forever. Never grow apart. Be with each other like you have been forever.
Nicole, you never cease to make me smile. You are my love. You are my light. You are my glowing orb of positivity to me and those around us.
So nervous at the moment. The butterflies are starting, but excited nerves.
There's an old Viking saying that pain shapes a woman into a warrior. Not only has Nicole endured enough heartache to earn that accolade, she is, in my eyes, the Viking queen.
So Rich, you ready to get married today, my boy?
I actually am not sure what getting married feels like, but if this is what it feels like, I'm pretty sad that I'm only doing it once. this is something else sort of feeling.
In the short time we've got to know you, Richard, I can safely say you have proven to be the man we as parents envisage our daughter to spend the rest of her life with. To both of you, I pray that as you journey through life, all your dreams are fulfilled. I urge you to always remain true to yourselves and each other. Strive to leave a legacy of excellence in everything you do. Maintain your carefree attitude, your sense of humor, your respectful and caring nature, and of course, your love for all creatures feline. Laura and I wish you much happiness, excellent health, a bunch of beautiful babies, abundant prosperity. My greener grass on the other side.
Very emotional, because I'm going to say goodbye to my son. I just can't. Every time I do my speech, I just can't.
Three things that you've got to do to make this thing last forever. Number one, you've got to practice patience. Practice patience. Be patient with each other. Just be understanding of each other. The second thing you've got to do is you've got to live in the present, not in the past. Because focusing on the past is going to get you nowhere and nowhere fast. Remember to focus on the present and the future. Forget the past. What we did wrong, we did wrong. Make amends for it and get on with life. Now the third thing we have is you've got to keep passion and romance alive. Always and forever.
With this ring, I declare my undying love, undying devotion, and undying commitment to you. I will stand by your side through good times and bad, in sickness and health, until death parts us.
Awesome. I think give him a round of
applause.
He's
my boy!
He's the main thing.
Thank you, boy.
With this ring, I declare my undying love, my undying devotion, undying commitment to you. I will stand by your side in good times and bad, through sickness and in health, for as long as we both shall live.
Now what we're going to do is we are going to witness something that is unique. They have written a love letter to each other. Because in 1 year's time, they are going to open this box together on the occasion of their first anniversary, and they are then going to share these letters. And that'll really be a fresh remembrance of what happened today. We call upon all here present to witness that you take Richard Cater Stevens as your lawful husband.
I do.
I do.
I declare.
Yes.
I declare that Richard Cater Stevens and Nicole Mercer Font are now lawfully marry now is your bride.
I'm gonna look at her and just cry.
Today is both of your days, but a special one for the bride. On behalf of the Stevens family, I welcome you with open arms. And I'd like to say thanks to your folks for making such a lovely daughter. This is something that Rich and I have spoken about many times. And I just thought I'd like you all to read it. And I'd like you to know how proud I am of the two of you for making it happen.
Nicole, you enable me and you enable us to soldier forward through life. Because of you, feel that there is no mountain too tall. Thank you for raising such an immensely deep, caring and breathtakingly beautiful daughter. And for her hand in marriage. Thank you. Thank you for that. Nicole, never change who you are. You are incredible. Cheers.
Nicole.
Nelson Mandela's birthday today, it was, and I think it's important just to maybe end off with one of his many sayings, and it says that when people are determined, they overcome everything, and I see you, Rich and Nix, as a determined couple, and you will overcome everything. Best of luck.
With that first drink of the summer,
I think about where you are. I dial 235, are you alive? How I miss our late night drives in 4-6. How is it that in my mind I flip a switch and 7-2 forgetting you is something I can't seem to do, even though we were just kids. I close my eyes, I'm waiting for the lightning strike to knock me back. Before we said goodbye. I still remember the house now, heart beating out of my chest, and walking up to your front. I dial 235, are you alive? How I miss our late night drives in 4-6. How is it that in my mind I flip a switch and 7-2 forgetting you is something I can't seem to do, even though we were just kids. I close my eyes, I'm waiting for the light back to 2005, before you took that cross country flight, before we said goodbye. Before we said goodbye.